Welcome to the stage, Jaguar Land Rover President and CEO North America, Joe Everhart.
Good evening and welcome to the fabulous Academy Museum of Motion Pictures and the public world debut of the all-new Range Rover. It is a pleasure to have you, some of our most loyal and passionate customers here in person, to be among the very first in the world to experience our new icon, the completely new fifth generation Range Rover. But tonight is more than a debut. It is also a celebration of you, the owners who have made Range Rover the global symbol of success and leadership. For the last few hours inside the Geffen Theater, we held a Range Rover Leadership Summit and explored how modern leadership is being defined every day across sports, business, culture, and so much more. You had the opportunity to hear from, amongst others, world champion Lindsey Vonn, Roc Nation's Big Bird, TIAA's Sasunda Brown Duckett, YouTube Angela Curtin, and the musical genius of Wyclef Jean. But now it's time for our newest icon, the all-new Range Rover. For over 50 years, Range Rover has been the most desired SUV in the world, combining peerless design and supreme all-terrain capability with sophisticated refinement and luxury. Tonight, we will show you how we have gone above and beyond in our newest product offering. I'd like to close with a famous quote by beloved author Antoine de Saint-Exupéry, who says, "Perfection is achieved
Not when there's nothing more to add, but when there's nothing left to take away. To me, the all-new Range Rover is perfection. Again, thank you for joining us here at the Range Rover Leadership Summit. And now, to introduce you to the new Range Rover, the benchmark for all modern luxury SUVs, please help me welcome Professor Jeremy McGovern, Jaguar Land Rover's Chief Creative Officer. Thank you.
Good evening, LA. It's lovely to be back here. It's nice and sunny in the day, not like in London. So we got something very special to show you tonight. Now, I know you've all seen pictures of it, but there's nothing like seeing it in the flesh. What are you lot talking about in the background? I hope you stop drinking that champagne. It's not good for you. Anyway, so I'm not going to show it you just yet. Just going to keep you waiting for a few minutes. Because the story of Range Rover started in 1970. And actually that was the year when it was the first vehicle ever to be shown in the Louvre in Paris. That's Paris, France, not Paris, Texas, by the way. And of course, the Louvre is the one of the most famous art museums in the world. Now, 50 years on, and four generations of Range Rover later, Range Rover's peerless character and its engineering supremacy has cemented its position as the world's number one luxurious 4x4. Ah, they're going quiet now. I'm not showing you yet. And of course, Range Rover is driven by world leaders, high achievers. Are you at the back, high achievers? Well, you didn't get there by talking too much, did you? Anyway, there they are. And members of royal families too. And of course, Range Rover lives in this world of luxury. We love luxury, don't we? Nothing wrong with luxury. And it's a world that has changed massively from when the original Range Rover was created, where sustainability, longevity have become increasingly important. But there is no true luxury without desirability. Desirability is the thing that creates that emotional connection. It can be anything. It can be a car, it can be a piece of exclusive jewelry, it can be a person. It could be a man, it could be a woman. I like to tell my wife that it was instant love at instant first sight, but that isn't always the case. But desirability is the key to customer desirability, and that's why it's the number one prerequisite of our design philosophy. Also, integrity, the integrity not just of the design, but of the engineering, the technical innovation behind it. And of course, for us, it's also about purpose. Range Rovers, Land Rovers have the ability to go anywhere and do anything. Now, this is the one that will shut them up at the back. We also embrace an aesthetic called modernism. What is it? What is it? You're going to see it in this car, because what it is designs that are clean, reductive, free from excess and over-ornamentation. No Zorro design for us. But these designs aren't clinical, they're not cold, they're warm, and they're emotionally engaging. And we already embrace this philosophy. You can see it there in some of our other vehicles, the new Defender, for example. And when I pull the covers off in a minute, and I will pull the covers off, that's a good tactic, isn't it? Don't say anything. Let's see if they stop. No, they're not going to stop. Anyway, so you will see it in abundance. Now, there are two quotes here before I pull the covers off, because I can see all the people at the front are really interested. Yeah? Of course you are. You're far more intellectual than the lot at the back. Yes? Okay. So, two quotes. And I'm sure the people at the front probably know this already, because I can see you've got excellent taste and you're highly intelligent. I can tell that by looking at you. So, probably the world's greatest modernist architect was a guy called Mies van der Rohe. Clearly, he didn't come from LA. But he made the saying, and you probably know it. All right. He actually did come from LA, but he did. LA in Germany. He did some of his greatest work here in America. Think of the Seagrim building for one in New York. That was just one of them. He actually coined the phrase less is more than Coco Chanel. Who knows who Coco Chanel was? Of course you do. Arguably the greatest and most sophisticated fashion designer ever. And she coined the phrase, luxury is not in the richness of things, but in the absence of vulgarity. Think about those two quotes, and the covers are coming off now. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce to you the new Range Rover.
I go by the name of Wyclef Jean, I'm your composer for tonight. You already know we in the vibe. Shout out to T in the building, we here. Right about now, if you feeling good, I know a lot about the West Coast. It's the best coast. Do me a favor though. Can y'all do me a favor? Stop using your phones and just act like this.
Every time that you come around, you're magic. Hey, I'm not finished with you yet. You know why? Because I need to tell you a little bit about it. Because when you purchase one of these and your friends come round on Friday night for dinner and they say, wow, that car's fantastic, tell me about it, you lot at the front will know exactly what to tell them. The lot at the back will be clueless, okay? So, look at it. There it is. Look at those magnificent proportions. Look how clean it is. It looks like it's been carved from the solid. Everything is flush. Flush glazing, flush door handles. Look how few lines there are on it. Look how taut the surfaces are. I could draw this car in four lines. The gently falling roof line, the continuous waistline, and the one body side feature line that runs from the front fender all the way to the rear fender. And then that bottom sill line that flicks up to give you that beautiful boat tail effect. Let's spin the car again and look at the front. Spin the car and look at the front. Sounds like we're in Las Vegas. The face of Range Rover, characterful. It communicates confidence and refinement and a hint of formality. From the beautifully resolved detailing of the front grille and the rear grille. And look at these lamps. Can you lot at the back see the lamps? No? Well, I can. And when you get close to them, they actually appear to look like they're cut from expensive glass, expensive cut glass. Let's go to the back. There's some very attractive people here tonight, aren't there? Yeah, I can see them in this car. I'm not sure about the lot in the back though. They look a bit scruffy. Now look at that back. That is a masterclass in reduction and simplicity, accentuated by this horizontal panel that runs the whole width and then terminates in these super slim secret to lit tail lamps. There you go, wow. And look at these haunches. Women can have cars. Women can have curves, but cars can too. Look at the curves on those rear quarters that give the vehicle this very tailored look. So, that's a quick overview of the exterior. Thank you very much. Give that lot a clap at the back. Yeah? Now, I'm nearly finished. I'm going in a minute. Now, the interior is equally compelling. Again, it carries that clean, reductive theme. In this world of 24/7 connectivity, this interior is all about calm sanctuary. Have a look at it in a while, because... Right, now on to SV. Let's put some lights on this SV, please. Bring the lights up. Wow, can you imagine driving down to the centre of LA in this, eh? The concierge will have a heart attack when he sees that. So, what SV is about is taking what is already a very desirable vehicle and amplifying its luxurious nature by the introduction of precious materials and material finishes. It's also about personalization, and you have the ability to personalize this vehicle to suit your own tastes and personalities. When you look at the two cars, the first thing you'll notice is that the grille designs are different. Five bar grille design on the upper and lower grills. And then as you walk around the car, you'll see that the wheels are different and other details. Now we've curated two versions. One is called Serenity, which is this, which comes in a icy white gloss finish.
with these contrast Corinthian bronze accents. It looks very, very prestigious. Those are the fundamental differences of the front. Now there's also one other theme which is called Intrepid, and this is in a sunrise copper red with a satin finish. It's beautiful and it adds anthracite and graphite detail differences, and that gives it a more stealth-like appearance. So, one other thing. Most cars will be following this car because this is the leader. The other thing that denotes that it's an SV is the badge on the back, which is made from ceramic, which is our symbol of modern luxury. Finally, the interior. This interior is spectacular, and there's lots of different versions of it. Lustrous materials, mosaic marquetry, soft aniline leathers, sustainable ultra fabrics, and ceramics. It is absolutely aspirational. Ah, and there's one other thing, and I'm not going to tell you about it unless the lot at the back shut up. Let's see if they shut up. No, they're not going to shut up. So, for the first time ever on a Range Rover, and it was by special request from America, in fact it was ordered from America, for the first time there's going to be a 7-seat Range Rover. And yeah, I knew that I'd get a clap. Wow. God, I've got a headache now listening to that lot at the back. So, it's at the back there. And that's on the long wheelbase, remember, to get all those seats in. So, ladies and gentlemen, the new Range Rover. It doesn't follow fashion. It doesn't follow trends. It's informed by 50 years of Range Rover's evolution and a modernist design philosophy. And it is the most desirable Range Rover we've ever created. And it's also the most technically capable Range Rover we've ever created. Thank you and have a good night.
It's time to party with Wyclef Jean.
Start this, Leon, real talk. Let's get working, man. If you're a Fuji fan, let me see your hands up in the air right now. We came to do what we came to do. Put them up. Let me see your hands up. Come on.
Ready or not, here I come.
You can't hide. Let's go, y'all. I'm gonna turn it up.
And take it slow.
Let's go, like.
Ready or not.